In this introduction to the course Location-Enabled Digital Government Transformation, we would like to explain what this course is about, how it is structured into different modules, but also why we believe it is relevant and important and how it could help you in gaining valuable new knowledge and new skills. The best way to explain the relevance and importance of this course is by looking at some key events in the lives of citizens, businesses, and public administration. Because this course is about citizens who want to move to another place, want to register their kids at school, want to establish a new company. It's also about existing companies, existing businesses who want to become active, selling their products, selling their services in other countries. It's also about public administrations, public services at different administrative levels and active in different domains. The course will deal with the key challenges most citizens, businesses, public administrations are facing on a regular basis, and in particular about how location data technologies could make the life of these citizens, businesses, and public administrations easier. Because although each of them have their own specific needs, their own wishes, there clearly are some common elements in what they want and do not want. What they do not want is to spend many hours, many days in looking for the information they need. What they also do not want is to provide the same information many different times to government. What they also do not want is to only interact with government by paper documents, by calling them, by visiting them. And overall, what they all want is that their government provide them their particular services and take decisions in the most efficient and effective way. Now, let us take the example of Anna, who wants to move from one European country to another. And for that, she has to take care of several things. It's not only about the actual move in the sense of finding a new house, selling her old house, and making sure her belongings are moved from the old to the new place. It's also about many other things she has to take care of, such as her car, which she has to make sure that it's registered and insured in her new country. To take care of this registration and insurance, Anna has to interact with several organizations, several public administrations, but also her insurance company, etc. And to these organizations, she has to provide quite a lot of information. And in a traditional situation, Anna had to provide the same information multiple times, many different languages, different formats, etc. In some cases, she could already take advantage or make use of digital forms, but in many cases, she still had to provide paper documents. She had to call these organizations, sometimes even have to visit them at their offices, etc. Which requires quite a lot of time, quite a lot of effort. Now, the information she needs to provide also includes some information about locations, for instance, on her current address, her future address, etc. And also here, sometimes she has to provide information in German, another occasion provides information in Spanish, etc. Also, these many different organizations involved in this process, in these services, they also interact, they also need to exchange a lot of data among themselves. Also, this requires some additional time, effort, because the same information always needs to be checked, processed, management, etc. Now, when we talk about location enablement, we talk about, in fact, improving these interactions, improving these processes through the use of location data and technology. It's about making sure that Anna has to provide the same information only once, after which this information is shared among all involved organizations in a truly interoperable manner. So no longer issue with different data format, different languages, many other issues that really takes a lot of time, make sure that results in the fact that this process without location enablement could take a lot of time, a lot of effort. So through location enabled government, she's able to complete both services in a very effective, very efficient manner by in fact taking optimally advantage of location data, location technology. Now, this is just one example. And in fact, to be honest, this example, the contribution, the role of location data is quite limited. But already here we see that using location data, using these technologies allows to really improve these services. Throughout the course, throughout the other modules, we will show you some more elaborated examples where even the contribution of location data is even much far-going, much deeper. So the focus of this course is on the transformation from a traditional government to a more location-enabled digital government, which fully takes advantage of location data and technology to provide more effective, more efficient services, but also to take better decisions, implement better policies. Looking at the services, it's also about cross-border services, cross-sectoral services, and this all should result in significant benefits to citizens, to businesses, government, and society as a whole. And for realizing this shift from a traditional government towards location-enabled digital government, we've identified three main building blocks, or you can also consider them as three main ingredients. It's about digital transformation, it's about location data and technologies, and also about interoperability and location interoperability in particular. So this course is in fact about the shift from a traditional government where we interact with our government via papers, via telephone, and via paper maps, towards first a digital government, and towards in the end digital government that is fully taking advantage of location data and location services for developing and delivering better services and better policies. This by turning on or by taking advantage of this location element, these location data technologies, they are able to answer new questions, solve additional problems, but also deliver new and more efficient services. So it's in fact this evolution from the very traditional government towards a location-enabled digital government that we will focus on in this course. Why the focus on location? We've identified here four main reasons, which I would briefly introduce here, but which will be further explained in one of the following modules. The first reason is the fact that the location element, location data, they really facilitate the integration of different types of data, data from different sources, et cetera, different data on different teams. So this aspect on data integration is one key element why we believe location enablement provides an added value to digital government. Related to this is the fact that by using this information, by integrating this information, governments will be able to take better decisions, data-driven decisions, which will in the end also have a positive impact. Third element is about the communication, about the fact that using location data, representing facts, representing things, issues, problems, solutions on a map, also again here integrating different data, this all eases communications with government, within governments, but especially to their citizens, to their businesses. And the fourth element is about the added possibilities with regard to modeling and simulations, where we see that location data enable more complex models and more complex simulations. These four elements, again, they will be further explained later in the course, are why we believe there's clearly an added value of location data and location technologies in realizing a digital government. Let me briefly introduce the four modules that are central in this course and which will follow after this introductory module. We have one module on digital government transformation, second module on location data and technology, third module on location interoperability, and then the fourth core module of this core is actually about location-enabled digital government transformation, where we bring together the ideas, results, concepts from the previous models to better explain what location-enabled digital government transformation is about and why it is important. Just a few words about each of these modules. Like I said, one module, module one, focuses on digital government transformation. Here we will explain what is digital transformation, why it is relevant for government, the chapter one of this module. Chapter looks two explains here what is the current European EU vision on transforming, modernizing public services. And then we have a third chapter that explains what public services are about and how we can well understand what these are and how they can be improved, transformed, etc. Module two of the course is about location data and technologies. Here we start with a separate chapter introducing many different types of where questions. And afterwards in chapter two, we first introduce what location data and technologies are, but also explain how these data technologies can help in addressing, solving these questions. We have a third chapter that looks at the different fields of application, but also here in this module, a case study on flood risk mapping. The third module is all about interoperability and location interoperability in particular. Two chapters here, one chapter that explains, that introduces and explains the European interoperability framework. Second chapter looks at what is interoperability in the context of location. And then the fourth core module of our course is actually about location-enabled digital government transformation. Three chapters here, one that introduced what location-enabled digital government is about. We have a separate chapter with two in-depth examples of what location-enabled government is, but also how the transformation towards this location-enabled government takes place. And then a third chapter in this model that looks at strategies and looks at the future challenges. To conclude this introduction, we just briefly summarize the main outcomes of this course. After completing the different modules, you will be able to first understand and explain what location-enabled digital government is. You will also know and understand how location data, technology, and interoperability are key enablers of improved public services. And you will also know what the benefits of location digital government are to citizens, businesses, government, and society as a whole.